Today we are looking at three-dimensional trigonometry. Now, everybody, we remember that the study of trigonometry is definitely study of triangle. And what exactly do we do with a triangle? Either we find length or we find angle. So those are the two main activities when we are dealing with trigonometry. Now here we have a 3D shape, three-dimensional shape. Our shape which we have today is actually a rectangular based pyramid. Now, this pyramid definitely tells the height. Height is that goes up and meets the base at right angle as I have shown. So what is our main activity? A, we want to find some length, that is length AC, length AO, and length OV. Actually, length OV is our height. Then B, we want to find angles between the given length. Angle between AV and VC, and angle between VB and the base surface. Now let's start with part A, Roman 1. We want to find the length AC. Where is the length AC? If you look clearly, this is AC. If I'm to create a separate triangle, AC, it makes a right angle at B, giving us 4 and 10. Now, in order for me to get A to C, I will use Pythagoras theorem. That is 10 squared plus 4 squared is equal to AC squared. Hence, I will have 116 AC squared. I will square root both sides and I will have my length AC as 10.77. That's our length, centimeter. Done. Then I find length AO. When you look at length AO, we'll clearly see that AO is a portion of AC. So what portion can you clearly see? From the center, it means our AO is half. So I will take 10.77, I'll divide by 2 to get 5.39 centimeter. This is our AO. Now, we look at Roman 3. Let's put it here. OV. OV is our height. If you look clearly, OV is creating for us A, O, and V. Remember, our slanting heights are 15. Meaning this side, we shall have 15. Then, O to A, we just found it. That is 5.39. So, to find OV, again, we shall use Pythagoras theorem. That is 15 square is equal to 5.39 square plus OV square. In order to get OV, I will bring 5.39 to the other side, giving me 15 square minus 5.39 square is equal to V, is equal to OV squared. Then I will simplify 15 square minus 5.39 square, giving me 195.9479 is equal to OV squared. Hence, my OV will be the square root of this. That is 13.99. We have finished this and that. Now let's look at part B. We are told to find angles. We are told to find angles. Now how shall we get the angles? B, Roman 1, they want us to find between AV and VC. If you look closely, AV, VC are all slanting and they're all 15. That means I will have 15 here and 15 there. AC, the one that is connecting this to the triangle, remember, AV, VC they are meeting at V, meaning the angle we are finding is here at V. But when you look clearly, AV, VC is creating a triangle with the line AC. And remember, this AC is our diagonal, which we already formed previously here. So we shall get a value and bring it to our shape, that is 10.77. Now, we want to find the angle between AB and VC. Clearly, if you look, we shall use what we call the cosine rule. C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared minus 2AC, 2AB, cos of the angle C. Then we shall substitute our values. C will be the 10.77 square is equal to 15 square plus 15 square minus 2, 15 cos of the angle. We don't know this angle is the one we are finding. So 10.7 square will give me 15.99. This 15 square plus 15 square for 15. 15 times 15 times 2, 450 cos theta. Cos theta will come this side. 450 cos theta is equal to 15, 450 minus 115.99 over 450 over 450. So theta will be cos inverse of the answer here. So as simple as 4.01 over 450. So cos inverse bracket 334.01 divided by 450 will give me angle 42.1 degrees. So this is the angle that will be located here, 42.1 degrees. When you look at part 2, VB and the base surface. What is VB? This is our length VB, and our surface is a rectangle. Now, rectangle will not give us a proper representative. From the rectangle, we must use the diagonal to represent the angle we are finding. Hence, by using the diagonal, we shall create a triangle from B to V and to B, and this is the angle we shall find. But remember, BB, VB are equal and they are 15, 15. Our diagonal is already 10.77. That's one way. Another way, remember, in the middle of height, if you bring back the height, meaning it is separating 10.77 to two parts, that is 5.39. So instead of using cosine rule again, I can now use Pythagoras theorem. That is 5.39, and the slanting is 15 to get this angle. And hence, this will be opposite adjacent hypotenuse. Hence, I will use cos 539 over 15. So the angle will be the cos inverse of 5.39 over 15, giving us 68.9 degrees. Now, this angle which we have formed here is 68.9 degrees. This is one example of three-dimensional trigonometry. That is, trigonometry inside three-dimensional shapes. Today we have looked at a rectangular-based pyramid. In the next chapter, we shall look at other shapes. Probably could be a cuboid. And we see how we can find angles and how we can find the length of sides in the shape. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, you can subscribe to my channel.